Okay, you're with us here on a fresh new edition of Midcap Radar. It's a Friday, last trading session of the week, and the market is off the lows by quite a bit. I mean, almost 80 points off the lows for the Nifty is what we have, and I think it single-handedly has got one stock to thank, which we will talk about in greater detail in just a bit from now, that is Reliance Industries. I mean, it was up 7.5%. I think it's cooled off a little bit. It's up 6%, which makes it 19% for the week. So that's the big stock by far for this week. With me, my colleague Sonal. Hi, Sonal.
Hi, Prashant. Good afternoon. Yes, you rightly pointed out a big recovery in markets is what we are witnessing right now. We'll cover that and a lot more information. But first up, the top headlines. Market recovers in trade led by the move in Reliance, L&T and Sun Pharma march ahead. Financials still under pressure, spooked by the winding down of six debt schemes by Franklin Templeton. HDFC Twins, ICICI Bank and IT majors trade weak. Faced with heavy redemptions, Franklin Templeton India winds down six schemes with total assets aggregating 25,000 crore rupees. AMC blames growing illiquidity in corporate bond market. Association of Mutual Funds assures investors say there is no need for panic redemptions. All 24 life insurance companies register an average 32% drop in premiums in March. Insurance regulators' decision to give 30-day grace for renewal is understood to have led to a deferment of payment. Aberdeen's Yu Young tells CNBC that the market will not see a V-shaped recovery, adds that the economic consequences of the current crisis are huge. Chris Woods of Jefferies removes ICICI and HDFC Bank from their Asia ex-Japan portfolio, adds Kotak Mahindra Bank.
Okay, so that's basically the top stories that we're tracking. Sonal, thanks for that. And we'll talk about some of them in greater detail. But let's talk about here and now, as we always do right at the beginning of the show. Hemen Kapadia is with us to run us through what he's making of trade right now. Hemen, I mean, this sharp pullback, in a way, came out of nowhere. It came out of Reliance, to be sure. 6%. What does one do, I mean, on the index?
A very good afternoon, dear Prashant. Thank you for having me. Absolutely. I think if Reliance wasn't what Reliance is today, I think we'd be at least 80 points lower in the Nifty as far as today's concerned. And over the last few days, yeah. So it's been a Superman, one of the strongest stocks. And it's, frankly speaking, been a jack in the box, actually. So without Reliance, things would have looked completely different. But yes, Reliance stands out with its outperformance. 1500, we could see some amount of profit booking, but yes, I think the recovery is riding piggyback only and only Reliance. IT participated yesterday, has fizzled out. I think it's pharma doing its bit today, but frankly speaking, it's been a one-way street and it's been only Reliance.
Oh, absolutely. But what are the stocks that you're trading on today?
A few stocks which look promising. I still feel Sonal, the bounce is not yet over. I'd like to reiterate, it's a recovery, not a rally. 12,300, 7,500. I think we spoke last week also. I think above 94, we could see 98. But beyond that, it looks very difficult. But we haven't been able to take out 94. But nevertheless, firstly, I have a sell call on ICICI Group. I think the daily picture has gone negative. A lower top, lower bottom. Crossover sells. And some negative divergence on the hourly and 2 hourly chart. So sell Prudential ICICI at 335, stop loss 345, target 315. Keeping in mind the pharma pack, Lupin has gone through the roof. I think Sun Pharma is on the verge of following suit. It's made a new high today in the recent days and should be breaking out. So buy on Sun Pharma at 490, stop loss 480, target 510. Lastly, a buy on Bajaj Auto. Bajaj Auto looks very promising. We've seen it give a breakout from a symmetrical triangle on the daily chart. There has been volume support and indicator support giving crossover buys, Sonal. So buy in Bajaj Auto at 2450 on a slight decline. Stop loss 2410, target 2530. All of these would be valid for till the expiry, basically. So.
Okay, Mr. Kapadia, thanks a lot for joining us. He says it's a recovery and not a rebounce. In fact, let's get in some more opinion, hear out what Gautam Shah has to say about where the Nifty and Nifty Bank can be headed from here. Listen in.
I think the market has gone through volatile distribution in the last 10 days. rallies to 9,400 have been sold into, dips to 9,000 have been bought into. But clearly, this recovery that started off from 7,500 levels is now getting weaker by the day. And I think in the next two or three sessions, you could have a snap out of this range, and it is most likely to be on the downside. So from a today perspective and for the short term, 9,150 is my working number. If this level were to get violated, you could see the Nifty going back to levels of 8,820, which I think is now a much bigger support. I have enough conviction on the charts to suggest the Bank Nifty can actually go on to revisit their previous lows of 16,000 and lower. If that were to happen, I think the Nifty is not going to be spared because it moves in tandem with the Nifty.
Okay, that's the word coming in from Mr. Gautam Shah, but it's time to slip into a short break. Up next, we speak to the management of Repco Home Finance on the RBI's TLTRO and the overall outlook for the NBFC space. Stay tuned.